So we came in Vrindavan, 12 days we lived very nicely, no any problems, without problems, Vrajamandal Parikrama going nicely, and everywhere we have done, and Harikatha, and Darshan, everything good. Now we came in Giddhāyat Govardhana. So Gurudev always spoke, Vaikuntha janito vara madhupuri tatra vina rasu savat vrindaranam mudaru pani ramana tatra vi govardhana radha kundam iya vi gokula pati prima mrita lāna. We are Gaudiya Sampradaya followers. And other of the Sampradaya, Vallabha Sampradaya followers. And Gaudiya Sampradaya followers rules is different.
सबको अपनाया आकर्षित किया
इस प्रकार भगवान ने ब्रजविलासी श्याम सुंदर के वृंदावन में गिराए। उस वृंदावन के साथ साथ जमुना के इस पार और उस पार, इस पार मधुवन, तालवन, कुमुदवन और बहुलावन, फिर जमुना के उस पार में लोहवन, महावन, माडवन, भांडिरवन, भद्रवन और बेलवन, उन वनों में भी लीलाएं की। इस तरह से कृष्ण की लीला हुई जो कि गुरु जी की आज्ञा थी और गुरु जी का अभिप्राय है कि लीलाओं का चिंतन, दर्शन, मनन और भावना बाल लीलाओं से ही होता है, जन्म से लेकर के प्रमाणाय से होता है। इसलिए मथुरा और वृंदावन का परिभ्रमण करते हुए हम लोगों ने उन स्थानों का परिभ्रमण किया, वहां के धूल कणों को स्पर्श किया और वहां की कथाएं वैष्णवों के मुखारविंद से सुनी। उसके पश्चात फिर हम लोग गोवर्धन आए। आज रास्ते में हम लोग सतवा शांतनु कुंड बहुलावन पार करके ही आए, सड़क क्लियर नहीं होने से हम लोग आ नहीं सके उधर में, जहां पर पोगंड लीला में पास में ही राल जो कि वृषोहन महाराज रहते, राल और छठीग्रह के बीच में बाटी बहुलावन है, जहां बच्चे एक दूसरों में परस्पर खेल कूद करते रहे, तो वहां की कथा भी अभी हम लोग सुनेंगे। और उसके साथ साथ हम लोग गिरिराज के तलहटी में आ गए, जहां बैठक चंद्र सरोवर में हम लोग गए और भगवान की जो नित्य रास लीलाएं हैं, बासंती रास इत्यादि विहार है, गोवर्धन की तलहटी की लीलाएं, तब वहां के वहां प्रणाम करते हुए कुछ कथाओं का अनुभव आस्वादन करते हुए हम लोग गिरधारी गौरी मठ में आए हैं। यह मानसी गंगा के सन्निकट गिरिराज जी के तलहटी में, जो एक समय गुरु जी ने कहा था, जब हम दोनों थे और माधव महाराज जी भी साथ में उसमें थे, प्रेमानपुर में और माधव महाराज जी को और गुरु जी से बातें चल रही थी गोवर्धन के जमीन के बारे में। ये जमीन यहाँ थोड़ा गंदा पानी भरा हुआ था, नाले का पानी आ जाता था, और आगे थोड़ा चल करके 10 बीघा जमीन और आगे चल करके 18 बीघा जमीन ऐसे मिल रहा था और सस्ते में। गुरु जी से कहा, गुरु जी आप कह रहे इस गंदे पानी में यहाँ गंदा पानी भरा हुआ है, कुछ जरूर को लेने की बात करते, हमारे तो समझ में नहीं पड़ रहा, और पैसे ज्यादा में और वहां सस्ता है, वहां क्यों नहीं लेते बड़ी जमीन। तब गुरु जी ने एक बात कही थी, देखो बीच में मैंने यहाँ आकर के भजन किया था, यहाँ एक छोटा सा बिल्डिंग था, 2 मंजिल का छोटा सा शास्त्री जी का एक बिल्डिंग था, उसमें रह करके गुरु जी ने पाओ समझता यहाँ भजन किया, गोवर्धन की परिक्रमा लगाई और एकांत में निश्चिंत होकर भजन करते रहे। तो गुरु जी बोले, देखो इसलिए मैं इस पर नजर डाल रहा हूं, मेरे जीवन का मैं कुछ नहीं कह सकता कि कब जाऊंगा कब रहूंगा, यदि मैं चला जाऊं और ये जमीन तुम्हारे लिए रहेगा कि यही स्मृति बनी रहेगी कि मैंने यहाँ भजन किया था, तो मेरे लिए भी भजन स्थली है और इसको तुम लोग चिंतन करना, मैं यहाँ भजन किया और एकांत रूप से यहाँ निवास। तो बोले कि ठीक है, जितना में चलेगा देख दिया जाए हो जाएगा, पर इस जमीन को लेना है, गंदा पानी भरा हुआ था, नाले का पानी खराब होता है, तो गुरु जी बोले हम इतना पैसा दे नहीं पाएंगे, प्रमाण तो बहुत है। प्रमाण तो बोले कि ठीक है, आधा हम देंगे आधा आप देंगे। उसी बात पर साथ के साथ जमीन गुरु जी से पूछा, गुरु जी इस जमीन में आप क्या करना चाहते हैं बताइए तो। मैंने पूछा, जल्दी हंसते रहे, बोले क्या है, ये छोटा मोटा कुटिया बना दे ना, जैसे कि यहाँ ये बिल्डिंग था वो भूत का जगह है, तुम जरा उसको भूत को भगा क्या ना। तो मैंने कहा अच्छा, यहाँ बच्चे आगे रह नहीं पाते थे, वो बोले कि भाई हमें परेशानी होती है क्या, समझ में नहीं आ रहा। मैंने कहा अच्छा, हम जा रहे हैं भूत भगा करके आएंगे। तो दरवाजा तो बंद होता है, ऊपर ऊपर नीचे चारों में घूमा, बोले यार यहाँ से भाग कौन है, तो भूत भगा के चल। फिर गुरु जी बोले भगा के आया, मैंने कहा हाँ भगा के, कोई नहीं है। अच्छा बोले कि इस बिल्डिंग को तोड़ देना, इसका नाम नहीं सब नहीं कर रहे, बड़ा खतरनाक बिल्डिंग है। मैंने कहा अच्छा ठीक है। अच्छा उसको तोड़ करके फेंक दिया गया, घंटे भी भर दी उधर में एक छोटा घंटा। उसके बाद में गुरु जी बोले एक छोटा मोटा भजन के लिए बना देना। मैंने कहा अच्छी बात है, कैसे भजन भी बनता है देखें। श्री रूप गोस्वामी पाद जी बोले के गिरिराज गोवर्धन की तलहटी में विप्ल राधा कृष्ण के विप्लंब रस के रसी, ऐसे जो गौड़ीय गुरुवर्ग महापुरुष गण भजन रस का आस्वादन करते हैं, उनके चरण सान्निध्य में बैठकर कुछ भगवान की कथाओं को सुनने का सौभाग्य प्राप्त हो, यही जीवन का परम लाभ है। आज हम लोगों के जीवन में यही परम सौभाग्य का विषय है, जब उनके वचनावली में ये है, श्रील रूप गोस्वामी जी के वचन में कि गिरिराज जी की तलहटी मानसिक अंतर संदेधाम में, जहां किलोट कुंड नारद कुंड रत्न वेदी रत्न कुंड उन सबके साथ में इस पावन स्थली में गुरुपाद पद जहां पर भजन किए और उन्होंने उसका मूर्त स्वरूप गिरधारी गौरी मठ को विशाल रूप दे दिया, जहां श्री राधा विनोद बिहारी गुरु गौरांग श्री गिरिराज विराजमान है और नित्य सेवा चल रही है। ऐसे स्थान में हम लोग गुरु के सानिध्य में आए। पिछले वर्ष यहीं पर गुरु जी को हम लोग कुछ साक्षात रूप से तो अनुभव कर पाए थे और उन्होंने अंतिम वचन भी सुनाया कि हम सबको यह अनुरोध करते हैं, आज्ञा देते हैं कि आप सभी प्रतिवर्ष ब्रजमंडल परिक्रमा और गौड़मंडल परिक्रमा में आएंगे, मैं आप सबके प्रतीक्षा करता हूं, मेरे वचन को अवश्य फॉलो करेंगे। मैंने बहुत सी बातें कही, भी पूरे विश्व में मैं गया और बहुत सारी बातें कही, इन बातों को अवश्य अवश्य फॉलो करेंगे और बहुत शीघ्र मेरे पास आ जाएंगे। ये गुरु जी के दरबार से कोई चेयर में बैठ करके माइक पर उन्होंने संदेश दिया, गुरु जी का हम सबके लिए यह अंतिम संदेश था जो यहाँ गिरिराज गोवर्धन इस प्रकार, जो कि यह गिरिराज जी गोवर्धन जहां पर राधा कृष्ण के किशोर लीला की स्थली है और राधा कृष्ण की किशोर लीलाएं भी है, और उन लीलाओं में महाभाव जो कि प्रेम स्नेह मान प्रणय राग अनुराग भाव महाभाव वृंदावन में यह विषय रखा गया था कि वृंदावन महाप्रभु कल भी वैष्णवों ने निर्णय दिया, मेरे घर में आकर के मेरे कमरे में बोले कि गोवर्धन में क्या करोगे क्या करोगे बताओ। मैंने कहा मैं क्या बताऊं, जैसे आप लोग बताएंगे। तो बात बात में बोले गुरु जी की तिथियां तो आती हैं, यहाँ पर है ही मिलन और विरह दोनों प्रकार की लीलाओं का स्मरण और चिंतन वर्णन होता है, मैंने कहा दामोदराष्टक के लास्ट श्लोक का वर्णन होना है और उसके साथ भजन रहस्य के कुछ कथाओं को प्रस्तुत करने का प्रयास किया जाएगा, समय यहाँ कम होगा। दूसरी बात, शाम को बोले कि जिस दिन जैसी कथाएं हैं उसके साथ साथ गंभीर आने महाप्रभु जैसे राधा जी का भाव वैसे महाप्रभु जी का भाव, तो हम लोग वैश्वर लीलाओं की स्थलियों में भ्रमण करेंगे जाएंगे। इसलिए इन सभी कथाओं की प्रस्तुति होगी, यही मैं आशा करता हूं। और केवल धूल मिट्टी के द्वारा वन जंगल और कांटे पुरुष के द्वारा वृंदावन को देखना नहीं है, वृंदावन को देखना है हमारे गोस्वामियों के गुरुवर्ग के भावों में वचनों में कि वो दिव्य वृंदावन क्या है। उस दिव्य वृंदावन की ईश्वरी जो विश्वहर नंदनी राधा जी, उनका भाव क्या है, जिस भाव के लिए, जिस भाव का छोटा मोटा काम प्राप्त करने के लिए दूर दूर विश्व से दौड़ करके यहां पर आए हैं सभी सौम्य के, उन भावों का चित्रण हो और उस भाव माधुरी का आस्वादन हो। इसी प्रकार कल हम लोग जो कि गिरिराज जी की बड़ी परिक्रमा में जाएंगे और परसों जो कि चकलेश्वर मानसी गंगा इत्यादि की परिक्रमा होगी जैसे प्रतिवर्ष होता है और दीपावली मनाई जाएगी और परसों अन्नकूट महोत्सव किया जाएगा उसकी तैयारी करनी है और सभी भक्त लोग इसमें उत्साहित होकर योगदान करेंगे। जिनको जो कुछ सेवा में समर्पण करना है अवश्य हमारे सभी महाराज लोगों के सामने, हमारे सामने सबके सामने प्रस्तुत करेंगे और यहाँ कथाएं होंगी। आज हम लोग रास्ते में बहलावट बाटी जहाँ राधा कृष्ण की मधुर बाल लीलाएं और उनका लीलाएं हुई है उसकी छवि भी प्रस्तुत करेंगे और कुछ कथाओं को भी प्रस्तुत करेंगे। सबसे पहले मैं आप सबको यह निवेदन है कि प्रतिवर्ष हमारे जो परिक्रमा चल रही है यहाँ पर अन्नकूट के पहले दिन जैसे परसों है चकलेश्वर मानसी गंगा हरिदेव श्री सनातन गोस्वामी आदि का दर्शन करते और भैया दूज के दिन अन्नकूट के दूसरे दिन भैया दूज होता है। भैया दूज के दिन में हम लोग राधा कुंड की परिक्रमा में जाते कि बड़ा अन्नकूट उत्सव फिर छोटा अन्नकूट उत्सव, दो दिन उत्सव मनाया जाता है और पहला दिन यहाँ बड़ा उत्सव होता है, दूसरे दिन फिर छोटे कुंड राधा कुंड वाला अन्नकूट उत्सव मनाया जाता है। तो इस रूप में यह अन्नकूट महोत्सव मनाया जाएगा तो राधा कुंड की परिक्रमा भैया दूज के दिन होगा। अभी और वैष्णव लोग बोलते जाएंगे तो उसमें और भी बताएंगे। राधा कुंड परिक्रमा 28 अक्टूबर भैया दूज जब द्वितीया डे दैट डे विल बी राधा कुंड परिक्रमा, हमारे राधा कुंड परिक्रमा जब द्वितीया दिने हबे और अन्नकूटेर आगे दिन आमरा एखाने परिक्रमा करे एखानकार व्यवस्था करते हबे अन्नकूटेर, আপনারা সকলেই অন্নকূটের জন্য অনুদান দেবেন যা কিছু সেবার জন্য দিতে চান। এভরিওয়ান অলরেডি এভরি ইয়ার সো গিভ হিম সো ডোনেশন ফর অন্নকূট মহামাস ফেস্টিভাল এন্ড ওয়ান ওয়ান্টস টু গিভ সুপার মহারাজ সাধন মহারাজ মেসেজ সিদ্ধ মহারাজ ভগবান মহারাজ এন্ড আদার সন্ন্যাসী সো এভরিওয়ান কালেক্ট সো মানি এন্ড this is for Annakoot festival. I want Annakoot festival will be every year. so very nicely. So in this way, this year will be more beautiful. In this way, prepare everything. Now, I request Sri Srimad Bhaktivedanta Madhava Maharaj ji, be कुछ प्रस्तुत करें और आज की कथा की प्रस्तुति साथ में उनकी जो मर्जी हो कुछ बोले।
eastern side of Yamuna. Although, due to the time, the Yamuna current changed here and there, but still pure forest is located there. Saint Bahulavan, in the Mahatma of Gajamandal Parikrama, it mentions that once one Brahman has so many cows, one cow is attacked by a tiger. Then Krishna came and protect. This is not digesting in my mind. So one day I asked Srila Gurudev, there are so many cows killed by tigers, bear, anything. Why this particular cow has protected by Krishna? And Srila Gurudev told that, do you know what is the name of this forest? I told, yes, Bahulavan. Krishna had so many cows. One of cows' name was Bahula. Due to the name of similarity, Bahula, and the Brahman cow name was Bahula. So due to similarity of name, Krishna came and protect the cow from the tiger. Srila Gurudev gave example, just like in Ajamil Upakhan in Bhagavatam, although Ajamil not calling out from Narayan, means Vishnu, he was calling out for his son into out of fear, but Bhagavan Narayan is causeless merciful. He sent four messengers who kicked out the messengers of Parsifal there. Then Ajamil understood how much glorified is Bhagavan's name. In same way, due to similarity, the name of Krishna's cow, so Krishna came and protect from tiger. Another, that Krishna's one, so his name was Bahula. That very place is the abode of Bahula Sakhi. So this is two causes, name Bahula one. Atharva had told, when Srimad Mahaprabhu was traveling all over Brajamandal, when he came in Bahulavan, seeing the loving quarrel between he parrot and she parrot, Sukh and Sari, then Mahaprabhu became extremely happy. So Sukh is glorifying Sri Krishna and Sari is glorifying Srimati Radhika. Each and every step, Sari is defeating Sukh, means he parrot. He parrot is telling, oh, Sari, listen, my Krishna is extremely beautiful. In this world, everybody bewildered by Cupid. Not only human beings, all living entity is bewildered by Cupid. And Srila Gurudev in the beginning is to tell stupid. In so many records is this there. I told Gurudev always Cupid will be stupid. Then one day Gurudev laughing and told, because the Cupid make everybody stupid. So I am telling stupid. After that Gurudev said, then he should tell Cupid. And Vajanandan Samsundar is so beautiful. I mean, Cupid could not bewilder him. So, when Krishna made rash dance after playing on flute, gopis came and this is Krishna's victorious over Cupid. Because according to time and circumstances, the living entity, they lose their intelligence and patience and they became bewildered. And when Krishna played on flute, the place was bank of Yamuna and time was night time, completely solitary place. Krishna is teenager and Gopi is also teenager. So there is no obstacle, but Krishna is control his mind and never bewildered by Cupid. Even in the middle of rash dance, Krishna give them up and went out from rash dance. With Radhika later on, give up Radhika also. So, he parrot is telling, oh sorry, listen carefully. my Krishna is Madan Mohan. Even keep it by virulencing his beauty. Then sorry to forget it. When my Radhika is left side of Shamsundar, then he is Madan Mohan. Otherwise, he is bewildered by Madan himself. Sukh bale amar Krishna Madan Mohan, Sari bale amar Radha bane yatakhan, noile sudhi Madan. Unless until my Radhika was not left side, then she is only Madan, not Madan Mohan. Then Sukh told, listen, my Krishna is so powerful, so strong. He lived at Govardhan for 7 days without any difficulty. Sari told, oh, don't be so much bhakta. You are telling that Sukh bale amar Krishna giridhare chilo, Sari bale amar Radha shakti sancharilo noile parbe kena. And Sari is telling, oh Sukh, listen. If anyone is doing something, how they can do? According to power. If you do wrestling match, who is more powerful than me, they can beat me. If he is less powerful than me, I can beat him. In same everything by power. So Krishna only desire. And Srimati Radhika fulfilling all Krishna's desire. So Krishna not lifted Govardhan. Srila Gurudev is to tell and emphasis each and every time Krishna lifted Govardhan. How? By Srimati Radhika's help. You can see Krishna lifted Govardhan. How? By right hand? No. By left hand. Over there. By left hand. And even left hand, not only left hand. From left, right, and then this is the leftest one. The pinky one, Krishna lifted Govardhan. Who linked Krishna's left side? Srimati Radhika. This is our monopoly, except in Gopinath Vigraha. So Radhika always there. So Radhika lifted Govardhan. In Braj, everybody thought Krishna is son of Nandababa Jasodama. They never considered him as Supreme Personality Godhead. If Krishna tell, oh, I am God, I do this, I did this, this, that, and look, under my soul so many auspicious marks, Gopis told, oh Krishna, look, our Swamini Radhika has more auspicious marks than you. So why so puffed up? Krishna told him to Sakhas, oh, I am so wealthy person, my father has 9 lakh cows. Imiyashita will tell, oh, forget it. I am more wealthy than you. My father has 11 lakh cows. So, tumi kon boro lok, tumi ami sam. What type of rich man you are? We are equal. So, Sakha never consider Krishna is Supreme Godhead. And for Vatsala Ras, either paternal mood or maternal mood, they never consider Krishna is Supreme Godhead. When Krishna lifted Govardhan, then all Brajavasis held a meeting headed by Upananda Prabhu, the eldest brother of Nanda Baba. And they invited Nanda Baba also. And they told, listen, oh Nanda, your son is not an ordinary person, ordinary boy. He must be any very powerful demigod or maybe God, because during name-giving ceremony, Gargacharya comment, Narayano Samo Guna. His all qualities as equal to Narayan. So from today, you should not treat him like your own son. Some may be telling, oh Krishna, can you bring my shoes? And Krishna also taking your shoes on head and became very happy and dancing, coming and putting on your feet. This is not proper at all. If suppose it's not Bhagavan, even demigod, this is not proper to do this. Even tell your wife Jasoda, he should not twist his ear, should not bind him. Nandava began to laugh and told, yes, the milkman when they became over 80, then became adult. Beyond 80, under 80, they are not adult. So your intelligence like a child is. So even he is demigod or maybe supreme godhead, I don't care. He came in this world as my own son. So I have to give him discipline. Unless until he learns the discipline, then he will be indisciplined. This is not proper. So I have to train him. And for Yashoda, he also treat him, never treat Krishna like a demigod or anything. Even when Krishna showed Mother Yashoda universal form inside Krishna's mouth, still Mother Yashoda never bewildered. Once during sucking breast milk, Krishna yearning, then Mother Yashoda saw universal form. Even Mother Yashoda saw himself inside Krishna's mouth, still she could not believe. Maybe I possessed by ghost, or maybe my son possessed by ghost. He stopped to give breast milk. Called priest, and they mixed cow dung and cow urine, and the tail of a black cow, then they do raksha mantra, the protection mantra for Krishna's body. Then give again breast milk and donate so many cows to Brahmin. Second time, when all boys are playing, and they complain to Mother Yashoda that Krishna has taken dirt. Mother Yashoda opened his mouth and saw universal form. Again Mother Yashoda arranged to abhishek by cow dung and cow urine by Brahmins. In this context, I asked Srila Gurudev that when Krishna became more aged, why he never showed his universal form to Mother Yashoda anymore? Then Gurudev told that when Krishna became aged, then he feeling some shyness. If he saw again universal form and Mother Yashoda give to maternal mood, she will do same thing, then gopis will tease Krishna. So Krishna, when became little aged, he never showed his universal form, then all gopis will tease him. Then Mother Yashoda give you birth with cow dung and cow urine. So only twice and small children after that never. Srila Gurudev told this. After that, when he lifted Govardhan, all sakhas think, oh, Krishna must be tired. It is too much for him. They put their stick. Oh Krishna, you are not alone lifting Govardhan, you are helping you all. And Mother Yashoda, he is feeding Krishna sweet butter and sugar candy. And all sakhas telling, oh Krishna, you can change your hand. Take your right hand, then you can massage your hand. And other side, all sakhis, especially Radhika, looking little angry towards Govardhan. Oh Govardhan, if you come down, then it crash you completely. You have no sign will be in this brooch. Gurudev is to tell, will be chaknachur, means small, small species. So Krishna lifted Govardhan, not who? Srimati Radhika. Then Sukh became very disturbed. Therefore, listen, my Krishna is so beautiful. And what he did? He has peacock feather on his crown. That, do you know why? Sukh bale amar Krishna sire moyur pakha, sari bale amar radhar namti tate dekha, namti tate lekha. Look, you are telling, he has become the Vinu Hawaii because my Radhika's name is there. By our eyes we could not see Radhika's name. Sari can see. So don't look. For this, Radhika is possible by him to show this. He has become feather on his head. Like who is superior to us, we go down the lotus feet and keep in our head. So same way, see, Radhika's name is there, so Krishna keeping on his head. And Krishna, Sukh told, listen, Sukh bale amar Krishna chura bame hele, sari bale amar adhar charan bave bole. Listen, that peacock feather leaning towards left side. Do you know why? Because Krishna want to touch the lotus feet of my Srimati Radhika. And Mahaprabhu became very happy that they came in mutual form. So, कैसे कृष्ण गिरा लिखा है एक भक्त ने लिखा कछु माखन को बल रहो कछु माखन करी सोहार परी सखन करी सोहार राधा जी की दृष्टि सो मैं गिरीवर लियो उठाए. कृष्ण इज टेलिंग बिकॉज माई मदर ऑलवेज फील मी सो मच बट समटाइम कृष्ण डोंट लाइक टू ईट. Then Mother Yashoda and Rohini telling, oh Kanha, if you not take butter, then you very lean and thin. Then your choti in Sikha will be very lean and thin. Look, your elder brother, Dao, is eating so much butter, how she is very strong, very chubby, very healthy, and look how Sikha is very thick and how long. Really, Mother? Bring Makhana immediately. Then Krishna is eating butter. So now Krishna is telling, how I lifted Govardhan, kachu makhan ko bol gayo, because I have eaten so much butter, butter give us strength. So due to some strength I receive from makhan, kachu sakhan kari sahai, and my all sakhas, they help me to lift Govardhan. Especially, Radhani ki drishti so, main girivar liyo uthai, and Radhika vice, sight long lens, he empowering me by the help of all these three, I lifted Govardhan. Srimad Mahaprabhu hearing the loving cord between Sukh and Sari became extremely happy. And each year heard Spatitvai about this Govardhan mot. I want to clarify something. The which land was possible near Kusum Sarovar, that land was very even cheaper than here. And when Buddha did bhajan, he was about 1 month here. Then Srila Param Gurudev and Guru Maharaj came to take Gurudev here to Mathura Math. Then Srila Param Gurudev told to Gurudev. Then Param Gurudev told to Gurudev, do you know this place is so important? Why? When Prabhupada Srila Saraswati Thakur did Brajamandal Parikrama, then he put tent in this area. Prabhupada Saraswati Thakur, all of his associates, so many devotees, they live here. So it is very important place. Then especially before that, we have Pujyapad Premananda Tirtha Maharaj. We and myself traveled so many places for mod. And Gurudev Prasad must be very close to Dhanghati. Then people can come down from bus stand and keep their shoes and bags and do parikrama. So where is Modi Bhavan today? There was some place available. And one devotee also was to help financially. Ram Prakash Agrawal, one of his very near and dear devotee of Srila Gurudev, he wants to donate for that land. Gurudev, I will not come so far. It is too far for me. Even nowadays, there is Iskan Mot. That mot also belongs to others. They want to donate to Gurudev. Gurudev, I will not go so far. So, for to remove the obstacle, Gurudev sent one of his disciples, Sundar Gopal Dasadhikari, his Gorimini Vasunari Lal Agrawal. He went to MP and contacted the royal family and removed all obstacles, then donated to ISKCON. And they promised they will keep 2 rooms for Gurudev. But although they never fulfilled their promise, and they never give anything for Gurudev. But they also want to donate to Gurudev, to I will not go so far. Even we went to our shop side, that side, this side. Do the college, no, this not, this not, let's reject. This place with the door, this. Then we told this is the best place. We don't know, I have so much money, I cannot do that. That place cheaper and bigger, I want to one third only. Then we thought that this place is not so good. According to security vision, this is very close to Manasikanga and security is here. As before, after sunset, no one is dared to walk in this area, in this way. When Gurudev established this mall and became so popular and real estate going 10 times higher than us before, then Gurudev told, okay, I have no money. What I have collected, I always spend in Devananda Gaudiya Mall. Gurudev did their Natta Mandir, complete smash and build new one. And Dharmasala there in guest house, did another floor. And purchased Mayapur land. And the school building, three-story building Gurudev did. Gurudev told, if you want, you can collect. Then Premanandu collected 20 lakhs rupees. And myself collected 20 lakhs rupees. And he land about 38 lakhs rupees at that time. After 1-2 months, Gurudev called myself and Premanandu building his lunch prasad. Before lunch prasad, we're going to take bath. All gone, myself, Premanandu, then Gurudev told, listen to one story of Prabhupada. Very good. Where is in the Jogpit Mandir, nowadays in Mayapur? Prabhupada had one disciple named Sukhi Charan Rai. When Sukhi Charan Rai, he purchased that land at his temple. Then one day Prabhupada told, Phaladive Akjan, Bhaddive Arakjan, means someone give plate and other will rice and dal and sabji there. That is Prabhupada told that he purchased land, so he had to make temple. So Gurudev told what he heard from Paramgurudev. Sukhi Charan not give the money in the hand of Prabhupada. He had fear, if I give money, Prabhupada use for preaching. So if I is under custody, he did make that temple. Then myself, Prabhupada, smiling to voice, telling this story to us. We told, you are both an intellectual, understand this simple thing? We don't know. We have purchased land, help for land, now help for temple. Then if I am telling this, not for myself, I have to praise one devotee, Father, I am telling. So Premanandu collected 14 lakhs, after that again he collected. One devotee, he loved me so much on sannyasi, his surname was Govinda Madhav, my name is Bhaktivedanta Madhav. So he treated me like his own Lala. And in the front of Giriraj Govardhan, in presence of Gurudev and so many Vaishnavas, he told, I will give 1 crore rupees for Giriraj Govardhan more. Then, after that he thought, 1 crore is 1 million. Then I told Maharaj, listen, you told in front of Gurudev, in front of Giriraj and presence of all Vaishnavas, you know the story of Nir Maharaj. What do you want? Then, to know what I told, I must have to fulfill. So he has land in San Diego. He sold that land, sold his car, everything, and completed 1 crore rupees. So if I not praise him, I will be ungrateful towards him and will always to joke with him. When he joined to Srila Gurudev, he was quite white cloth. Whenever he come, Gurudev will push him, not allowed to come close to Gurudev. And he became very disminded. Then I used to console him, used to give Gurudev prasad, used to pull him near Gurudev. He became more near and dear to me. And after that, Srila Gurudev gave him sannyas and told, I want to make you naked statue on the top of roof. And Gurudev used to tell him, Guru Bhargava Gurujan, Gurudev told, I will make a naked statue of top of Giriraj Govardhan temple. And Gurudev, no, 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 you are touching, you are yourself, I will be living statue for you. So his name is Sri Bhaktivedanta Sajjan Maharaj, donated 1 crore rupees at that time. And Gurudev used to joke with him always. So I don't take more time, other devotees will tell about Chandrasarovar and Paithar. So we are dedicated to Sri Bhakti Sajjan Maharaj. who helped Gurudev by this way. Hare Krishna Sajjan Maharaj ki jai. One more request. Before speaking any other speaker, I am requesting to Pujya Padmanabha Maharaj to announce some news to which you have heard. One very near and dear friend of Srila Gurudev and good brother of Padmanabha Pujya Padmanabha Maharaj, and he helped my grandson Srila Padmanabha Swami Maharaj before from this world today. So I want to request Padmanabha Maharaj about to announce this message to everyone. Hare Krishna. I'm sorry that I am violating the rule. So he also helped Gurudev, so I am requesting Padmanabha Maharaj before other speaker.
IGV Chiyakam, the area which is managed by